Our planet Earth is surrounded by a deep blanket of gases extending several thousands of kilometers above its surface. This gaseous cover is known as the atmosphere. Like the land, that is lithosphere, water, that is hydrosphere, the atmosphere is also an integral part of the Earth. The atmosphere is a mixture of gases. In addition, it contains huge number of solid and liquid particles, which is collectively called aerosols. If we consider the changes in the atmosphere with height, we come to know about very interesting things about it. Like the average atmospheric pressure at the sea level is about 1000 millibars. But as we go higher in the atmosphere, the atmospheric pressure decreases with increasing altitude. One half of the atmosphere lies below the altitude of only 5.6 kilometers. So the Earth's atmosphere can be identified as zones or layers arranged like spherical cells according to altitude above the Earth's surface. Different types of physical and chemical properties are found in different altitude zones in the atmosphere. There may be variation in density, atmospheric pressure, chemical and electrical properties, temperature, etc. in different parts of the atmosphere with increasing altitude. Based on these changes, climatologists identify five zones in the atmosphere, which is also called the structure of the atmosphere. These are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, ionosphere, which is also called thermosphere, and exosphere. The lowermost part of the atmosphere in which we live, in which most clouds form, and where all weather phenomena takes place, is called troposphere. It contains about 75% of total gaseous mass of the atmosphere, and practically all the moisture and dust particles. The average height of the troposphere is about 13 kilometers above the sea level. And under normal conditions, the height of the troposphere at the poles is about 8 kilometers, while at the equator, it is about 16 kilometers. This difference in height is because of high temperature near the equator and subsequent convection current that develops there, and low temperature near the poles. Troposphere is marked by turbulence, various types of cloud formation, thunderstorms, as well as the cyclones and anticyclones, and most of the weather phenomenon occur in this sphere because of concentration of almost all the water vapor and aerosols in it. Wind velocity also increases with height in this layer and becomes maximum at the top. The most important feature of the troposphere is that there is decrease of temperature with increasing height at an average lapse rate of about 6.5 degrees Celsius per kilometer or 1 degree centigrade per 165 meters. However, there is an abrupt change in the lapse rate at a height of about 14 kilometers, which marks the upper boundary of the troposphere. The zone that separates the troposphere with the next atmospheric layer is called tropopause. As the name indicates, tropopause, which means where the mixing stops. The tropopause has the greatest height near the equator and is lowest near the pole. It is the upper limit of the most clouds and storms. The second layer of the atmosphere is stratosphere, which begins at the tropopause. The lower stratosphere is isothermal, that is, temperature neither increases nor decreases in the lower levels of stratosphere. However, temperature starts increasing in the higher level of this layer. There is maximum concentration of ozone between 30 to 60 kilometers in this layer, which protects the Earth from harmful ultraviolet rays coming from the sun. Jet planes also fly in this layer as it is free from atmospheric turbulence or disturbance. This layer of the atmosphere extends up to a height of about 50 kilometers and is separated from the next atmospheric layer by stratopause. Next atmospheric layer is mesosphere, which is above the stratosphere and which extends up to a height of 80 kilometers. One important feature of mesosphere is that temperature starts decreasing with increasing height in this layer and reaches minus 100 degrees centigrade at a height of about 80 kilometers. The upper limit of mesosphere is called mesopause. Ionosphere is the next layer of the atmosphere, which is located between 80 to 400 kilometers above the mesopause. It contains electrically charged particles called ions, and hence it is known as ionosphere. Here, ionization of the air molecule starts taking place. This layer is very important for radio transmission. Radio waves transmitted from the Earth is reflected back from this layer of the atmosphere. Temperature starts increasing with height in this layer. This layer is also called thermosphere because the temperature becomes very high in this layer. The uppermost layer of the atmosphere above the thermosphere is called exosphere. This is the highest layer of the atmosphere, but very little is known about it. Atmospheric gases are extremely rarefied in this layer and it gradually merges with the outer space. This division of the atmosphere in different layers is called structure of the atmosphere.